local accounts versus Microsoft accounts. Which one's better? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got just the other day. Why does a local account trump a Microsoft account? These two types of accounts have slightly different characteristics and both have pros and cons, of course. Which one's better? Depends mostly on you. Local accounts are, well, as the name implies, local to your PC. They are login accounts that you create specifically to that computer. You set up a username and a password, and then you're usually also asked to provide a password hint or answer some questions or whatever so that you have the opportunity to recover the password if you forget it. Local accounts work seamlessly offline, and they have no cloud integration. Microsoft accounts are set up online with Microsoft, and they're used to sign into one or more PCs. When you set up a Microsoft account, you have the full range of sign-in security options, including two-factor authentication and passkeys, and you can even configure your account to have no password at all. Microsoft accounts can work offline as long as you've signed in at least once and give you access to the plethora of Microsoft online services. So, privacy. That's typically where most questions arise. Some people are concerned that using a Microsoft account might cause more telemetry and usage information to be fed back to Microsoft. While a Microsoft isn't technically required for this kind of collection, it does enable more, and perhaps more importantly, more accurate information collection because you might be using that Microsoft account in multiple places. A local account, on the other hand, well, you can't trace it across multiple Microsoft services or multiple computers since it's local to a single computer and has nothing to do with online services. While Windows still sends back some telemetry data, it's not nearly as all-encompassing as it might be if you're using a Microsoft account. Now, there's a, I'll call it a dichotomy concerning security in Microsoft accounts. On one hand, it's an online account, and that means it's subject to all the risks of any online account. Therefore, of course, it's important to keep that account secure. In theory, if you lose access to the account, you could lose access to your PC, or at least have what I would consider to be a much more difficult time getting back in. On the other hand, it's an online account, so it can use all of Microsoft's account recovery options. If set up properly beforehand, this can make losing your computer's sign-in password, also known as your Microsoft account password, a non-issue, because you just go online and recover the account. A local account has neither the added risk of being hacked, nor does it have the added benefit of having all these additional account recovery options. If your password hint doesn't remind you and you can't answer your secret questions properly, recovering that local account becomes, well, difficult, if not impossible. Freedom? For Microsoft? A local account on a PC has no access to Microsoft's online services. You might get pestered, often, to set one up or to use one to enable a Microsoft service, but as long as you don't, your machine remains independent-ish. What's most notable, given the recent frustrations around OneDrive, with no Microsoft account in use, OneDrive can do nothing, including doing no harm. Now, I did say independent-ish, and that's because this is still Microsoft Windows. And much like the telemetry I talked about, there are certainly Microsoft services that don't require a Microsoft account. In fact, some of them are important, like keeping Windows security, anti-malware databases up to date, and so on. So having a local account is not a complete detachment from Microsoft. At the other end of the spectrum, if you're heavily invested in using Microsoft services like OneDrive, Copilot, Microsoft 365, using a Microsoft account on your PC makes the integration easier, if not seamless. It's possible to access all these Microsoft services while using a local machine account, but you'll have to sign in to those services separately with a Microsoft account anyway. Once you do, Microsoft has been known to start using the provided Microsoft account in more ways than just the service you've signed into. For example, say you use a local account to sign into your machine. You sign into the OneDrive app using your Microsoft account. Windows now starts using that Microsoft account for more than just OneDrive. There are cases where it's even become the machine login account in place of or in addition to your local account. Nonetheless, if you're all in on Microsoft services, or even just mostly in, signing into your PC with a Microsoft account can make a lot of sense. So, bottom line, well, which one's better depends on you. It really does. If you don't trust Microsoft, and you don't plan to use any or few Microsoft services, but you still need to use Windows, then a local account is probably the way to go. If you're a heavy Microsoft user or you want the security of an online account recovery, using a Microsoft account will make your life easier. And remember, you can have more than one account on your machine. I do. I do my day-to-day work in a Microsoft account because I'm using lots of Microsoft services. But I also have local accounts on this machine that I use for other things that are not, again, as tightly woven into the Microsoft ecosystem. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/173892. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.